people in this room that know more than I do, in fact. But, you know, once they started wavering off the books, everyone was sort of lost. So, I don't read the theories anymore. But I have a pretty bad feeling about my character, to be honest. That's my personal feeling.
So what's your feeling?
Yeah, I'm not gonna make it, man. If I were the writers, I would kill me off.
Who will kill you then? What's your prediction?
Doesn't really matter.
Doesn't matter?
I mean, Arya would be fun. She would kill me. No?
Yeah, maybe. I would see you then, like Jon Snow killing you off. That would be cool.
Yeah, but, well, that's very nice. Jesus.
Hey, you gave me the place to choose. It was my choice.
Fair enough, fair enough.
Thank you. Next one, please.
Kto waszym zdaniem powinien ostatecznie zasiąść na
żelaznym
tronie?
Who should win the game from who by your choosing should sit on the Iron Throne?
Samuel Tarly, but yeah. It's never gonna happen, you'll know that.
Obrigado, bem Martin, mamy zgaszać, pięknie klima. Cieszę.
You didn't choose your characters to sit on it, actually. Till the end. Okay, next one, please.
This is for Carice, actually. Hi, here. I just wanted to ask, when you were preparing for the role of the Red Lady, where did you look for inspiration? Like, did you look for other witches' characters? Did you search, read any fantasy books? Where were you looking for preparation?
Just in my fantasy, I think, my own fantasy, somewhere in my head. Because it was tricky because this character basically looks like nothing, looks nothing like me at all. Like, I don't feel like Melisandre is sort of part of me. I have no idea who that woman is. I don't want to be close to her, I don't want to be her friend. You know, that's not my kind of woman, so I didn't really feel that it was easy to tap into her. But it helped, I guess the preparation for me was mostly just being very, trying to be as confident as I can be. And the wig definitely helped. When I wear the wig, I feel, you know, feel more like her. And the necklace that always itches me, and I always feel like, I want to take it off! But, yeah, you can't. So yeah, preparing, I guess, the wig and Melisandre never slouches like me. Like I always sit, and she never does that. She's always straight, always straight. But, you know, until season six a little bit, yeah.
Okay, thank you. Can we have the next question, please?
I want to say that I love you all so much. I love this serial, and I have a question for you. How it is kissing Jon Snow?
How it is to kiss Jon Snow?
You would like to know that, huh?
I think all of the girls want to know that, not only her.
I didn't really kiss him, did I?
And now you've heard the dreams of the girls. Come on, make something up, come on.
Yeah, make something up. Oh, it's really nice.
It's smooth lips. Oh, come on, make it play.
It's funny because both my mother and my sister also have a sort of a crush on him. So every time I was resurrecting him, and we did it, I don't know, 1500 times on the day. Like, there were so many takes we did to bring him back alive. And I was saying to kids, I said, oh, if only my mother would be here. She was so jealous of me. No! Because I could touch his body, like, over and over and over and over. But, you know, yeah, what can I say?
Do it the short answer, it was nice.
Right, yeah. And talk too much, it's okay.
Next one, please.
Hi, I'm Jacob, and I really appreciated your acting skills in the series, especially your scene with Davos. And I must say that I really love you for bringing back Jon Snow.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
So it wasn't that bad after all.
We saw the trailer of the 7th season, so I would like to ask, what would be your role in the 7th season and the relationship between Jon Snow and Melisandre? What will be the relationship? Will she be trying to seduce him, you know, or what?
It's funny because you think that I'm really going to answer your question. I'm not. Sorry, they're gonna kill me. They're gonna kill me anyway, I guess, but they're gonna kill me, sorry. And I don't think if I would tell you, I don't think anyone would really want to know, because I think if I would start saying something, people would be like, don't you think?
But you know that you can throw some fake news, you know?
Oh yeah, that I'm eating Daenerys, yeah, for dinner. Yeah.
You know what will enter?
And we have some dragon flying lessons, and all sorts of crazy things are going to happen.
You know what would tomorrow happen in the internet when you say such a thing?
Yeah, I didn't think of this before. I should have thought about some good fake news before. Maybe I'll think of something.
Thank you.
Sorry, I can only say that it's going to be great. It actually was a little the stuff that happens to my character I'm talking about now. I saw it coming a little bit, is all I can say. And the rest is gonna be so great. You're gonna see so many different storylines get, you know, crossovers. Different characters meeting each other for the first time, all that stuff's gonna happen. So, yeah, here I'm gonna stop because it's getting dangerous.
The big journey is coming to an end. Everybody has to meet. Thank you.
First, about Mom, in book, this character is a little arrogant, but in movie, it's not speak too much. How do you feel playing this character?
I enjoy it a lot. It's a challenge for me. It's definitely an experience for me to play such a bad man, because I'm just a big teddy bear, to be honest.
So he always makes me laugh when we're on set, on Game of Thrones set, not on the Black Butterfly set. He made me laugh there as well. But on Game of Thrones, his hand was cut off, right? So he has a hand like this. That's not funny, but he has this glove he has to hold his hand like this all day. So it's sort of cramping, and he just sometimes just makes me laugh by just doing.